What's up, zombie slayers? This is KG48. Welcome back to my 7 Days of Dice single player Let's Play. This is episode 6, and it is in the morning, and I have been working on my tools, got them up to green. I've been working on my weapons, got them up to green. I think I am ready to go. I've gotten everything that I pretty much gonna need right away, and we are going to head up north. It's like directly north, and we don't even have to mark it. We just have to head north, that's all. And we're gonna go to the new town called Perishton. I've been told that there's a lot of dogs there and cops and nasty SOBs, so that's why I've got all my arrows ready to go. I've got my weapons. I mean, granted, these aren't the best weapons in the world, but they're what I got. And we're going to go up and see what we can find in the north. Maybe I should head north, huh? All right, I'm very excited. Before we go up north, I actually wanted to bring something to your attention. Bing, bing, bing. Can I have your attention, please? My construction tools is now 20, and I am now going to unlock the ability to make concrete and the cement mixer. What? And then I'm going to unlock the workbench. Workbench, hi! A lot of people have been asking me what the workbench is for. Well, it's very simple. The workbench is just another way for you to craft stuff that doesn't include your inventory. So it kind of like helps you craft stuff quicker. Really, really cool, and I'm really looking forward to using it. It's not like a workbench like in Minecraft or anything. It's not going to give you new recipes, although maybe in the future, you know. But it's basically just going to give you another way to craft. Like, you see when I do a lot of crafting in here, it kind of locks up my inventory. The only thing about it is you are not going to get experience for crafting those items, which is fine. It's more than fair. We got a bear over here. We want to avoid the bear. Bears have a lot of hit points. I could take the bear. Probably pretty easily. You can just kite him around. But you know what? I just don't want to waste the arrows. I expect to see a lot of dogs where I'm heading. And I do not like dogs in this update. I have not fought many dogs in this update. But from what I've been told, is this... Wait, actually, what day is this? I didn't even think about that. One second. Scrap. There we go. And this is day 4. So, oh my goodness. Just so you guys know, like you new players, every 7 days you will get a mega horde. You know, it's not so bad on day 7 or 14, but it starts getting really bad starting on day 21. And every 7 days you'll get a mega horde. There's no hiding from them. They always know where you are. And, you know, it is what it is. And the reason I'm bringing this up about dogs is because you also get a dog horde every 2 days before the mega horde. So, you know, the day 7 mega horde, you'll get a dog horde on day 5. The day 14 mega horde, you'll get a dog horde on day 13, and so on. Dogs are a bit of a pain. They actually upgraded them. They made them a lot faster and tougher and nastier. But then they nerfed them back a little bit, so I'm not quite sure where they are. We're actually 2 updates past where my last video was. They put out like 2 updates pretty much back to back the other day. The only thing that was relevant, I mean, well, they did a few things, but why am I looting this? I don't have what I need for it. They've been doing a lot of balancing changes, a lot of different stuff we're going to get into. I'm kind of waiting for the dust to settle with their balancing changes. Like, basically, they made cobblestone a lot worse. Iron walls are a lot better. Flagstone is actually not a bad defensive structure. It's actually in a lot of ways better than cobblestone. Cobblestone doesn't break down in stages anymore, I've been told. I haven't worked with it, but I'm just letting you know what I've been told, and I've heard this from many people, so I believe it. There was one thing in the update that was... Oh, one thing they did change is they made the bows and crossbows not 100% accurate. You know, Fun Pimps, you could be a little bit more clear. but yeah, I mean, like, I'm not sure what that means, but I did some testing on the multiplayer server, and I didn't really notice much of a difference. From what I've been reading on the forums, the nerf to the bow and crossbow is more of like a... Sorry, I didn't notice you were already dead. The nerf to the bow and the crossbow thing... You know, we're going to need a chest. Let's go ahead and make a chest. Is there anything we can eat? Is there anything we can get rid of? Not really anything. Well, you know what? I don't need the blueberry seeds if I have blueberries. There we go. All right. Yeah, so I haven't had any problems with the bows or crossbows, thank God. And there were some other things they changed, but honestly, I don't remember. I want to show you one more thing on the skills that I was giving some wrong information because they changed it and I didn't know they changed it. The way it used to work was your skill would, like, these skills would cost as many points as you had in the skill. Like, if I had 4 points in archery, for me to put a skill into archery, it would cost 4 points. If I had 20 points in archery, the skill would cost 20 points. Now everything's just 1 point, and they give us less points per level now, which I think is a good idea, because like in Alpha 13, I'd have like 500, 600 skill points, and you'd use them like 80 or 90 at a time, depending on what skill you're going for. I think it's a much more elegant setup now. There was something else with that update. Another thing I want to show you, bottom left-hand side, the food UI thing is now working for me, thank God. So they fixed that. And, man, I thought there was something else. One of the things you guys want me to talk about in Alpha 14 was no more... The Fun Pimp said there will be no more world resets. I don't really have a preference to that either way. By the way, if your bow ever, like, sometimes your bow will get glitched out and your hand, your bow will be right in front of your crosshairs and you can't see. If that happens, just switch to another weapon and re-aim if you have the time. Oh. Alright, let's do some meleeing. There we go. Nope, you're still alive. Not anymore. Alright, so this looks like a pretty interesting town. Oh my goodness, look at this. You know what? We really shouldn't be killing zombies. We're going to take this and we're going to scrap it. I'm going to scrap more. Wait, I can't scrap the last two, can I? Yeah, you get brass for that now. That's pretty cool. Boy. Let's eat that. Oh, look at that. Pears. I've never seen pears before. Pears give you gas, huh? Well, I need these. This is getting bad. All right, I gotta break these up. I didn't want to have to break those up, but you know, I had no choice. We can't break those up. We can't eat those. I don't care about those arrows. We need to find a place to stay, or at least to drop off our stuff. It does not have to be our permanent home, but I think we're just gonna go in this house right here. It might not be a bad idea to actually live in this house, because we can up our construction skill even more by upgrading walls like so. I might just do that as well. Also, anytime you're breaking down a wall, if you're using the construction tool, that raises your construction tool level. So I might use these construction tools until at least level 40, because once I'm at level 40 construction tools, I can then get steelsmithing. So if you see me using, a stone axe when I have something better, you'll know why. You know what? I might actually stay here. I would like to stay in a stronger house, but the fact of the matter is, this is not going to be my permanent base anyway. So, yeah. I want to stay in Dyersville, man. I miss Dyersville. Dyersville used to be my place, man. That's where I used to chill. It was awesome. Love Dyersville. Alright, okay. I eventually want to start a farm, but I think I'm just going to loot for tonight. And then I'm definitely going to start a farm within the next couple days. I didn't even see these down here. Read that. I always end up getting these damn hunting rifle schematics, and it's the one gun I don't really like. Well, no, actually there's a few guns I don't like, but whatever. Let's not loot this house right now. First things first, let's just mark this on the map and let's plant some trees. I was worried there wouldn't be a lot of trees around this place, and sure enough there are not. So we need to put some trees. I don't want to put them in town. I don't want them getting knocked down. So let's, should we put them on a slope? I don't think we're going to have an option. Over here doesn't look too bad. Yeah, let's just put them right here. Come on. Not possible, huh? Why not? Why the heck not? Oh, ooh, how come that didn't hurt me? It's cactus. It definitely should have hurt me. I ran right into it. Not that I'm complaining, but it's just kind of weird. All right, there we go. And this is going to be an entire day of looting. We just got to loot. Loot, loot, loot. We're going to look for the specialty stores first. That looks like a church. Oh, look at that little bridge over there. That's pretty cool. Okay, so it is going to be hot in here. We could go for a bandana. and a cowboy hat. And honestly, iron armor. Although I don't think we know any iron armor, do we? No. We don't know any iron armor. All right, let's get to work. We're going to need a bandana, though. I was considering staying here, but now I'm definitely not going to stay here because of the damn heat. Oh, this is a pretty cool looking backyard. I like that. Oh, you know what? I don't have my wrench. Did I ever have a wrench? Damn it. I don't even remember. All right, we're going to have to try and find a wrench. Did I ever? Nope. Ah, damn. That's not good. We'll look for the specialty buildings first. Oh, this is a really neat looking town. Damn, seriously. Wow, good job, Pimps. This is a good-looking town. Kudos. Oh, look at that. Oh, sniper tower. Oh, man. Oh, I kind of want to stay here now. Crap. Oh, my God. Look at that building. It's so smexy. Look at it. Ugh, it's not fair. Oh, it's not fair. We got to check out this building. God, that's a good-looking building. Oh, dogs. Oh, let's get away from it. So I was told that there's only one place in the town where the dogs and cops will spawn, and that is the building, apparently. I've been told you can't outrun the dogs while running backwards anymore. Although I do not know if that's the case. They look pretty fast to me, but not fast enough to dodge my arrows. Alright, so let's, we left our wood frames. Ugh, we left our wood frames. What, you know what? Ah. Is there any trees around here? Yeah, you know what? I take it back. I wouldn't want to stay here. There's no damn trees. Actually, you know what? The fact that there's no trees here is going to actually be a big problem. Because me staying here for the day 7 Hortus is like, is based, oh, hold on. Is based on me having wood for spikes. Oh, stop walking side to side, dude. Seriously. I hear dogs. Yeah, this is not good. Not with a bow. Alright, let's take care of these little douchebags, and then we'll try the cop. Groin shot! Another groin shot, you're already dead. Okay, copper. Man, the cops sound scary now. Dude, the cops sounds nasty. You know what, guys? We're going to overheat. Alright, we got no choice. What we're going to do is we are going to come back here. We're going to make a bandana and possibly a hat. And I'm going to do this on camera because I want to show you how awesome these are. Basically, if you're overheating, guys, there are certain clothes in the game that will, you know, I don't have any cloth, do I? There's certain items in the game that will lower your, basically have negative insulation. And that's what you're looking for. So we're looking for the bandana that has negative insulation and the cowboy hat, which is actually fiber. All right, let's get some fiber. Someone else said I should be getting grass with the axe. It's not a terrible idea. If you punch grass, your athletic skill goes up, which helps you with stamina. And if you use the axe, your construction skill goes up, which helps you get, you know, your construction items. So it's going down now. Okay. All right, now we can go fight the cop. Freaking no good piece of crap, cop. Where is he? There you are. We're not going to be allowed to fight them by ourselves. We got to take these guys out first. All right, you. Had enough of you. Ooh, thanks for the grain alcohol. It's a good find. There goes your head. And, ooh, you're lucky. Give me a little quiet here because I need to concentrate. Oh, frig you, lightning. Turn up the landscape, bro. Die already. Ah, couldn't get him. All right, that's fine. We killed him. That's all that matters. You got to kill them before they blow up if you want their loot. Their loot's usually really good too. But you know what? Oh my god, seriously? When all you have is a bow and arrow, nah. I'll be happy with the win. You know what? We need some trees. Let's see if we can get some wood over here, guys. Hopefully there aren't too many cops and dogs. While we're doing this, let's make frames. Actually, you know what? No, I take it back. Let's just save the wood. I'm going to save them for spikes, because I would like to stay here for the Horde Night. And if I stay here for the Horde Night, I don't have enough wood for spikes, that's going to really make a boring Horde Night, or a loud Horde Night. Maybe not so much boring, but loud. I'm going to survive it no matter what, but it would be nice to be able to kill the zombies too, or else they're just going to keep yelling and being loud mouths, and that's annoying. Oh my goodness. Alright, I'm actually going to do some looting now. And then, oh, the bank. I heard about the bank. Let's go check out the bank. Apparently there's like some vaults here, and if you break through them, there's a lot of stuff behind them, but the doors are really tough or something like that. Alright, I'd like to put this on for the light. Alright, let's just go in the back room. Oh, okay, here we go. This is good. Bathroom's usually good for pistols and healing items. Although, I don't think I'm gonna find any in this one. Nope. Oh, here we go, the vault door. Okay. Yeah, I'm not gonna break. What, why wouldn't you just break through the... Oh, that's a problem. That's a problem, Fun Pimps. You could just break through the wall. I just want this to go a little quicker, so I'm going to use this. I'm assuming there's more, like, brick behind this. Otherwise, the door makes no sense. Come on. Oh, okay, it's got Oh. Can we slip through there, you think? It's worth a try. Okay. Oh, wow. Eat it, Fun Pimps. All right. Wall safes all over the place. We'll come back here. I'm not going to do this on camera. It's nice to know I can get in there, though. Oh, we should go for that. Yep, let's do it. I'm not screwing around with this. Yeah, more cops over there. This is a really cool town, though. I like this town. And it's not just because it's new. It's actually very well designed. Alright, we're going directly southeast. This should not be an issue. Should not be an issue. Oh, that lightning, man. It's scaring the crap out of me. Does it always rain here, or... Man, we should stay in one of these brick buildings. The thing is with the brick buildings, we can't upgrade them to upper construction skill. Living in a wood building is nice, although we don't have a lot of wood to upgrade the wood building, so it's kind of pointless. But whatever. I don't know. Maybe we'll move. Yeah, maybe we will move, because I'm not going to have enough wood to upgrade that wood building no matter what. I'm going to need that wood for spikes. Not going to be able to upgrade the wood building. And if you can't upgrade the wood building, it's a pretty soft building. So I think we'll actually move into a brick building. We don't have to do it tonight anyway, or even tomorrow night. We're good. I'll just scrap these to make some extra room. Get rid of this glass. Eat the dog food. Scrap the can. Meh. I don't know why I'm finding such low quality weapon. I think it was 71. Wait, how did I even find a weapon that's got 71? I have quality Joe perk. Like, I thought quality Joe perk adds... Oh, it only adds 25%. Okay. Or 25. Not... I thought it was 75 for some reason. My bad. Still, I mean, I've got a pretty decent... I don't know. I guess my scavenging skill isn't that high. It's only like 9. I might want to start pumping skills in my scavenging skill. That takes a... Scavenging skill actually takes quite a long time to level. So... Yeah. I'm definitely going to move into that brick building. Definitely. It doesn't look like it's too wide to upgrade the spikes. Plug up a couple windows. Should be okay. Should be okay. Freaking dogs. What are you, blind, you mutt? I'm gonna end you. Eh, forget him. He's just running around in circles like a dumbass. Whatever, keep running around in circles, idiot. Oh man, look at how close these buildings are together. That's pretty cool. Wow. That's really neat. Imagine staying in one of these buildings. The way they're so close together. You probably wouldn't even have to put spikes in there. You'd only have to put spikes out front. Oh, this is like downtown, man. I love this. Should we stay in one of these buildings? It'd be cool. I could hop from rooftop to rooftop. I'll just put spikes around the outside where they're not touching. Man, alright, you know what? It's probably not a great idea, but I'm going to do it anyway just because it'll be neat. We got to loot everything, get our scavenging skill up for sure. Actually, you know what? This might be the wrong decision. I'm not saying this is the right decision. But I'm going to pump up the scavenging skill. Just, it takes so long, you know? I'll put it up to 15. The tool and die set's not bad. Should I even scrap those auger parts? I know they're weak, but... Don't come in here, zombies. I will end you. Which one of these buildings do you think would be the best one to live in? Probably one in the middle, right? Let's go see. I definitely want to live with one that's touching another... Oh, freaking cops. I definitely want to live in one that's touching another one. It only looks like ever two are touching, though. It doesn't look like more than two are touching. Oh, right here. No. No, they don't put more than two touching. I wonder if that's on purpose. Nope. Oh, well. It's okay. Alright, so where do you think I should live? Let's get this done first. Okay, so you can't outrun him backwards. Actually, you might not be able to outrun him at all. No, I'm outrunning him now. No, I'm not. Yeah, you can't outrun him. I was running forwards. I wasn't running up a hill. I was sprinting the whole time, and he still caught up to me. Interesting. Yep, dogs are no joke. The way you can avoid him is by, Whoa, look at him. Look at him go. The way you can avoid him is by, is hitting them. Because it hurts them. Like, it stuns them. I'm not even going to bother shooting at that cop. I'm not going to really get him without him exploding. So, just a waste of my time. Alright, we need to find a place to live before I, end this video. Whoa, this place is crawling. Alright, I think right here. Right here will be just fine. Okay. All right, guys, we're going to call this one here. That is going to be it for episode 6, and we'll see you next time for episode 7. Till then, take it easy.